For this advanced section, we need the real-world repository with bunch of commits, with multiple authors, that has multiple branches that are active, some branches should be merged, and so on. And you can choose any public repository you want. You can even choose your own repository if you have one. I'll choose, for example, Vue.js repository that is available under github.com/vuejs/vue. It is a really popular JavaScript framework, and actually doesn't matter whether you know JavaScript or not, we will use this repository just as sample repository for performing different advanced tasks, such as, for example, stashing, rebasing with squashing, and so on. So please clone any repository of your choice to your local computer in order to proceed to next lectures. I'll clone this one, I'll click here on clone or download button and copy this URL. After that I'll go to terminal and as usually cd to desktop and here enter git clone and paste copied URL. Again, I'm simply cloning one of public repositories. Okay, let's press enter. Cloning into Vue. It may take some time because this repository is relatively large. You see how many objects it has, more than 50,000. So let's wait a bit. Okay, cloning was successful and now I can cd to Vue folder and here you'll see that default branch is dev. And this is indication that default branch at GitHub was changed from master to dev specifically for this project. And now I'll add this repository also to source tree. Let me go there and close this repository and add here existing local repository because now Vue repository is actually local on my computer. Let me choose this folder and click open and double click on this repository. And this repository was opened in source tree. And immediately you see that there are some branches under development that were not yet merged into main dev branch. Also you see that some branches before were merged into master branch. For example, this branch, branch 2.6, was merged into dev branch. Okay, let me also add this repository to GitHub desktop. Let's go there, GitHub desktop, and here let's click add and add existing repository. Add local repository, choose, and I'll choose same folder, this one, and click open and add repository. Okay, this repository was added here as well, and the current branch is dev. One more step left here, and I'll open this repository in Visual Studio Code. Let's go there, click here, file, open, and choose same folder, this one, and click open. Okay, we are all set and now we are ready to proceed and in the next lecture I'll show you some advanced options that you can use with git log command. I'll see you in the next lecture. Bye-bye.